face to face, I embrace debate. I don't make mistakes, I just make my case. Drop spike when I'm done, what more can I say? Not bite to my tongue, I don't like the taste. I'm on and I'm on and I own my opponent. I'm always in a zone, need a zone, out of zone. And then we could get it poppin', pick the topic if you watchin'. Skip and Shannon, skip the hoppin', took these sports and made them pop. Alright, undisputed.
Happy Monday morning, everybody, and thanks so much for joining us here on Undisputed. I'm Jen Hale, here with Skip Bayless and Shannon Sharp. Hi, guys.
Good morning, good morning. Jen, how are you?
Happy special on Saturday night, watching the Lakers Summer League game. I thought I would see you sit next to Bron down on the baseline at the game because you're the fifth horseman, right?
I got in.
Were you hanging out?
I was there Friday. I got really? In. And I got see how I do, see how I move. Really? You didn't even know I was in this summer at the Summer League in Vegas.
So you went to the after party.
It was the afterburners.
Right?
Yes. It was a rough one for your boy.
Yeah. And so what happened there will stay there.
Stay there.
You and LeBron both.
Yeah.
Okay, that's what I expected.
Mm-hmm.
Next.
What happens at Club Shay Shay in Vegas?
Yeah, definitely stays. Thank you, Jen.
All right, guys. A ton to get to this morning, so let's jump right in. Over the weekend, both LeBron James and Russell Westbrook sat courtside at the Lakers Summer League game. Westbrook sat near the Lakers bench while LeBron sat baseline digitally across the court. The two never acknowledged each other before, during, or after the game. Not a good look, but Shannon, way in here. Is this a big deal or no, not really?
This is not a big deal, Skip. I think there's a misconception that because guys are teammates that they have to be best friends. You can be friendly, but not necessarily friends. Skip, we're not on a date. You know, sometimes I would go to a bar and, you know, to see, have me a chair, and then the chair next to me is open and somebody come. I was like, no, I'm expecting someone. That's not what LeBron is. LeBron says...
You're turning away young ladies?
No. Oh. But Skip, I'm expecting someone to sit in the chair next to me, so I'm holding that seat. LeBron James, it's like maybe they got there at different times. Maybe LeBron got there early, Russ got there late. Maybe Russ got there early, LeBron got there late. But they're not holding... These are grown-ass men. I'm not holding a chair for a grown-ass man. Hey, I'll meet you after, if that's going to be the case. But because these guys... Skip, I think these guys... are cordial. I think they're friendly. They were teammates, and so they established a better friendship than probably what they have. I think everybody, you know, to say, you know, everybody is like Clay and Steph and Draymond. They do things on the road and they get together and they hang out. That's not necessarily true. I mean, I've been on teams, we won championships and we were cool, but everybody wasn't buddy. And I don't think you have to be buddy. So I'm not gonna make too much out of this. Plus, the fact of the matter is, Skip, look, let's keep this all the way 1,000. LeBron James is about winning championships. I think he finally come to the conclusion that he cannot win a championship with Russ. Russ style is not about winning championships. Yeah. Russ style, you can get to the playoffs. Oh, he'll get you a triple-double, but what does that equate to? And at the end of the day, LeBron James is not about making the playoffs. LeBron James is feast or famine. Is title or bust, is title or nothing. And so for me, Skip, I'm not going to read a whole lot into it. You know, sometimes guys, you know, teammates, they see each other and they sit next to each other. But this is a situation, there's a good chance that Russ is still not going to be on this roster. He might. He just might. But Skip, I don't want to make too much out of this. I don't, and I'm not going to. Like I said, we're not 10 years old. I'm not saving a seat for my friend who arrived a little late and I know he is coming. Oh. That's not what's happening here.
Shannon Sharp.
Yes.
I regret to inform you, this isn't a big deal. This is a huge deal. I'm going to remind you, just 1 year ago, about now.
Yeah.
Russell Westbrook and LeBron James were conducting a bromance in Las Vegas. Mm-hmm. And all we heard about, all we had read about was that LeBron and AD had recruited Russ, had invited him to late-night sit-downs up in LeBron's cigar room on top of the Brentwood Mansion, right? Mm-hmm. And with cigars, tequila, wine, all of the above, they had finally convinced Russ that he was exactly what they needed.
No, Russ convinced them.
I think it was the other way around. That's how I read it, but who knows? Unless you were there, maybe you were there.
They didn't see that.
I don't know. You are the fifth horseman. But the point was that just 365-ish days later, they don't acknowledge each other. They went from sitting next to each other and giggling through the whole game, sharing private inside jokes, whispers back and forth, to all of a sudden, Russ doesn't even, during a timeout, walk down to the baseline to pay homage to LeBron the way everybody else did. Because every time I looked up, somebody else was going down to pay homage to the king as he held court down on his baseline. And we saw my Vanderbilt coach, Jerry Stackhouse, went down there, and James Jones, his former teammate, and obviously Miami and Cleveland, now the Phoenix GM, who's doing a great job. He went down to pay his respects. I saw Baron Davis down there. Obviously, I saw Pelinka. Then I saw Kurt Rambis. Then I saw Darvin Ham. Everybody was going down there, all the new Lakers, Thomas Bryant, Toscana Anderson, and obviously THT was sitting next to LeBron in the third quarter. So everybody goes down there except for Russ, who sits almost on the bench. He was sitting right next to the bench. And in one timeout, I look up and I see Russ participating in the sideline huddle, telling my little man, Scottie Pippen Jr. from Vanderbilt University, about how to do it. And I'm thinking, oh, that's a horror story, because I'm not sure you want that guy teaching anybody anything. And by the way, we'll get to this in a few minutes. I'm here to tell you right here, right now, that I believe that Scottie Pippen Jr. would be a better fit with LeBron than Russ would be this coming year. I believe that with all my heart and soul, and I watched him a lot at Vanderbilt. He just knows how to play. That's just me.
Okay.
All right. So the point was, Russ's body language is like he's re-empowered, like he's part of the hierarchy, so he's going to sit by the bench and be part of the action internally with the Lakers. And obviously, he was the only one who showed up at Darvin Ham's introductory media session, right?
Yeah.
Because Darvin had gone out of his way to do what had been suggested, to have some lunch/dinners with Russ. Mm-hmm. And obviously, he had re-ingratiated the organization with Russ, and Russ was sticking his chest out at the introductory news conference because he wanted to be there to show his support for a coach who was showing his public support back to Russ, right?
Okay,
so the Cold War has started, because what happened in the exit interview with the media after the debacle of a 33-49 season, remember, the media asked Russ about, well, all year long, LeBron and AD were saying, you got to let Russ be Russ. They were supporting him, trying to empower him on the basketball court. And remember what his response was? Well, that wasn't true, said Russ. Let's be honest, that wasn't true. And then he went on to say, were you allowed to be yourself? And he said, very rarely. There were times and spurts, but I was just trying to find my way, honestly. Well, I think you interpreted that as a between-the-line shot at LeBron and Anthony Davis, right? And I'm pretty sure the King didn't like that one, because after he went completely out of his way to ingratiate Russ, now he gets that back right in his face.
Well, the thing is, Skip, KD let Russ be Russ, and it got him nowhere, so he left. James Harden let Russ be Russ. It got him nowhere. He's like, okay, either he goes or I go. Bradley Beal let Russ be Russ, and what did it get him? So letting Russ be Russ, it will have him. He will look great, but you're not going to win a championship. Kyrie's going to be a better fit. Look, everybody knows that. Everybody knows that. Right now, Kyrie is a better player, is a better fit for them. Now, when it's all said and done, when Kyrie's career is over, Russ's career is over, you can look back and you can judge them accordingly. But right now, as a fit for the Lakers, who gives them a better chance? With LeBron and AD to compete for a title, I believe it's Kyrie.
Well, you mean over Russ?
Yes!
Well, I mean, it's just absurd you even bring it up.
Yes!
I mean, right now, Kyrie is 10 times better playing basketball. If he plays, he's there, he's 10 times better than Russell Westbrook.
Yeah.
He plays.
And I get it, Skip, I get it. Last year this time, there was a courtship going on, but this thing lasted about as long as a Liz Taylor or Kim Kardashian marriage. It was less than a year. Mm. And it's over.
Well, Kim's had some...
Well, she had Chris Humphrey was 72 days. Okay. How was that one? Okay. Liz Taylor had a couple of them that was
no,
what?
Those were,
okay.
Those were overnight.
So people at home that don't know who that Liz Taylor is, she had a couple of short ones, real short ones. This is a very short marriage. Well,
they should know who Liz Taylor is. If they don't, they should check it out.
Yeah, you know
I generate. She was something.
Yeah,
I got to tell you.
Yeah.
Okay. So the point is that we're on this incredible collision course because it's starting to feel like, and I could be wrong, as you say, you could be wrong, but it's really starting to feel like Jeannie Buss blessed the hiring of Darvin Ham, but mandated to him, you will figure out Russell Westbrook because he ain't going nowhere. That's how it comes across to me. And it feels, and again, they could just trying to pump his trade value up.
Right.
But we'll get to the quote from last night on the broadcast.
I don't know how you fill a balloon up that has a hole in it.
Yeah.
I don't know how you increase his trade value. He is what he is.
Well, they saw the tape.
Yeah, exactly.
They saw the balloon.